I will inform him personally in the mini chamber. Let me see if he has
a chapter for you. Huh? जहाँ जहाँ पढ़ी चुनवा सब दही ठीक लगता है मो पकड़ लेके दे हम देखी
डॉक्टर मनोज हेलो हेलो डॉक्टर मनोज
Now, thank you, sir. Sorry, sir. In the last moment, I got disconnected. Now it is okay. Am I audible, sir?
Yes, yes, you are audible.
Sir, thank you, sir.
Manoj,
very good morning to one and all present over here. Honorable President, MSI, India, Professor A.M. Deshmukhji, President MSI Odisha Chapter, Professor N. Behera, sir. Dr. D.K. Nanda, moderator of this session. Then Dr. Sushil Kumar Sahu, coordinator, MSI, GIT, University. The staff and students from different universities and my students. It is a great day for us. That we are going to arrange.
1 minute, sir. 1 minute. Please, mic of someone is open. Again, request everyone to close the mic. To mute the mic. Okay, you proceed. Proceed.
So, my hearty welcome to this student-student interaction, which is organized by Microbiology Society of India Odisha Chapter at GIET University Gunpur. Today we have chosen a very good topic, that is strain improvement for industrial microbiology, which will be delivered by Mr. J. S. Amitya Bania, a student of MSc Life Science GIET University. And this topic has high value and more interesting, and I hope that this topic will helpful to the students to know about the what are the different methods are being used for improvement of the strain. I am thankful to Professor Behera sir, under his active guidance this session has been organized. I think that such type of activity will be helpful to the students a lot. The student who will be going to give the speak, he will be get into deeper into the topic. He will get less, that he can reduce his stage fear, as well as it will be encouragement to the other students to come prepare for such type of topic. I hope that today's interaction will be helpful to other students as well as it will provide your knowledge on this topic. At last, I also once again welcome all of you, sirs. Thank you. Behera sir, Professor Behera sir,
Okay, I think I am audible now. So, Honorable President, National President MSI, Professor Deshmukh, Dr. Manoj, Dr. Sushil, Dr. Dheeraj, Dr. Jatin, Dr. C.B. Datta, Dr. Devraj, Dr. Haraprasad Mahapatra, and all the faculties and the participants for this talk program actually. So this is a second talk of the student interactive program in the series. We started this talk in the Government Autonomous College Sundargarh. That was the first talk. It was very successful. So after that, this is the second talk. And even I have told that there will be chain of talk. This chain is going to continue one after the other. In fact, we have got 4 talkers ready right now. And it is going to be done. So I am very happy that President is joining this talk program and his words are going to be very encouraging for the students to continue this program. And also equally happy that a GITian, J.S. Amartya Baniya, a student of MSc Life Science, he is going to give a talk. The topic of the talk, as has been told, is very interesting and it's an evergreen topic. And always it is going to be a problem and solution provider for the industrial microbiology. So this much I will be telling that with this, I welcome Professor Deshmukh sir. And we are very happy and we feel encouraged that you have come to join this talk in spite of your busy schedule and all that. So I will request now Professor Deshmukh to speak few sentences for the students for the encouragement. Professor Deshmukh.
Thank you, sir. I'm really happy to see the enthusiasm of Orissa Microbiology Society chapter. And I'm more happy that you have inspired a student not only to conduct the program, but also to deliver the lectures. So it's a golden moment in the history of Microbiology Society that the students are delivering lectures on various topics. So it is my duty as a president of Microbiology Society to attend such program and to encourage students doing such activity. So, again, I am thankful to GIT University for arranging such a wonderful program and Dr. Niranjan Behra, as well as all coordinators for promoting the student and inspiring the students. As a president of Microbiology Society, I do not have words to express my happiness. I am thankful to all of you and assure here today that I am always with you for such academic program. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Behra sir, please unmute. You are not audible, sir.
I thank Professor Deshmukh for his kind presence and kind words for this. In fact, this is going to be a chain of events, one after the other. The talk is going to proceed and all that. So thank you once again. Now, without spending much time, now we'll move to the talker, Mr. J.S. Amartya Baniya. to deliver the talk. So, Mr. Amartya Baniya, please.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah.
Sir,
Amartya,
you. Sir, it is disabled. Sir?
Is it saying disabled?
Yes, sir. Sharing skin is disabled.
Sir, actually, host has to allow for screen sharing.
Sushil.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes,
sir. Sir, actually, host has disabled for sharing the screen.
Sir, Behra, sir.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I request host to allow for screen share.
Behra, sir, please allow.
Okay, sir.
Or you may make me host, I will allow.
Okay, sir. Please allow. Sir, so I request you, please allow.
No. First, you go on the participant list.
Participant list. Yeah, participant list. Okay.
Go on AM Deshmukh.
Admit all and then.
AM Deshmukh. Go on AM Deshmukh.
Okay.
Because you are host now.
Oh, yeah, just a minute actually.
Or you can directly allow him to share his PPT.
Okay. If this is possible, then that will be better actually. Okay. Yeah. So this, I have got your name, so I will click there.
AM Deshmukh.
Sir, Professor Deshmukh. Yeah, I have got it. So I will click there.
Click here. So there are, yes, I'm co-host. Thank you.
Okay.
Sir, I have make you co-host now.
Okay, now permit for presentation. Share the presentation. Permit. Dahikar, sir.
Yes, sir.
Please permit for sharing PPT. Can you permit for sharing the PPT?
Yes, sir. You are now co-host, sir. You can present.
No.
You can share now, sir.
No. Who is? One minute, please.
Amrat Baniya, sir.
What is the name of the speaker?
Amrat Baniya.
J.S. Amartya Baniya.
Amrat Baniya. Yes, I am making him a co-host.
Okay.
He's a co-host now.
Okay.
Very good.
Okay, yeah, it has come.
Okay, very good.
Okay.
Yes, he can proceed.
Yeah, Sushil, you tell Amartya to proceed.
Amartya, you make your screen bigger and you proceed with your presentation. Amartya.
He can click on slideshow. Yeah. Very good. Okay, he can proceed.
Okay.
Yes, tell him to proceed. Amartya, you can start speaking.
Yes, sir. Good morning, everyone. Honorable A.M. Deshmukh, sir, President, Microbiology Society of India. Respected Professor N. Behra, sir, President, Microbiology Unit, Odisha. Respected Dr. Manoj Das, sir, Sushil sir, Nirmal sir, Deepthi sir, and other faculties. Sir, I am very much thankful for giving me this opportunity. I would like to thanks, especially thanks to Sushil sir for selecting me and guiding me. I am J.S. Amartya Baniya, MSc Life Science from JIT University. I am going to present the seminar on the topic of strain improvement for industrial microbiology. So these are the contents: introduction, need for strain improvement, ideal characteristics of improved strain, approaches for strain improvement. First one is mutant selection. Second one is recombination. Third one is recombinant DNA technology. Then novel technologies, application, conclusion, and references. So this is the introduction. So what is strain? Strain is a group of species with one or more characteristics that distinguish it from other subgroup of the species of the same species of the strain. Each strain is identified by name, number, or letter. So what is a strain? Basically, a strain is specific to microorganism or a group of bacteria that help and it applicable into the production of product or in the fermentation process. Or a strain is a genetic variant or subtypes of the species. As it is different from the subgroup. It is different from the subgroup of the same species of the strain. And it is identified by a name, number, or letter. For example, E. coli strain K12. It is a specific type of strain of E. coli. Escherichia coli. Here, Escherichia coli is the bacterium name. And a specific strain is K indicates the letter and 12 indicates the number. So another example of E. coli specific strain is E. coli strain 0157S7. So here also, this is here also H is the number, H is the letter, and these are the numbers. So this is the example of another type of specific strain. And another example of bacterium or strain are Lactobacillus plantarum 299B and many more. Then what is strain improvement? The science and technology of manipulating and improving microbial strain in order to enhance their metabolic capacities is known as strain improvement. So it is majorly involves in the process or iteration of the genetic alteration or in fermentation techniques or assay for the numerous biotechnological applications on the industrial microbiology. It is more efficient marketing techniques for attractive packaging. It is genetically improvement of industrial strain which occurs. Then what is the need or purpose of strain improvement? So first one is increase the productivity, regulating the activity of the enzyme, introducing new genetic properties into the organism by recombinant DNA technology and genetic engineering. So first one is increase the productivity. That is, after an organism producing a valuable product is identified, it becomes necessary to increase the product yield from fermentation to minimize the production cost. So when a valuable product is identified, we need to increase the amount of product and also to minimize the production cost. That can be done by strain improvement. Then second one is regulating the activity of the enzymes. So it can also regulate the activity of the enzymes. Generally, enzyme can be regulated by changing the activity of a pre-existing enzyme or changing the amount of substrate. This can be done by strain improvement. Third one is introducing new genetic properties into an organism by recombinant DNA technology or genetic engineering. So by strain improvement, we can introduce a new species or new genetic variant or new genetic species or specific step of strain into the recombinant RDT technology so that we can further modify a product or get a desirable product. And product yields can be increased by the following strategies. For example, what is the process or strategy to increase the product's yield? So generally, for example, in fermentation, generally three processes are there. Or three strategies are there. First one is developing a suitable medium for fermentation, refining the fermentation process, and improving the productivity of the strain. Then first one is develop a suitable medium for fermentation is developing is very much important. Then second one is refining process is also very much required. Then third one is improving the productivity of the strain. So major improvements are seen by strain improvement. Therefore, industries are now focusing on strain improvement. So nowadays, industrial microbiologists majorly perform strain improvement that can be very helpful, productive, higher yielding product or low cost, and it also fulfill our desires. Then, what is the ideal characteristics of improved strain, or what can we get? What type of characteristic we can get after strain improvement? And first one is the rapid growth. Those strain which are selected for the fermentation or production of a product are rapidly grow. Then second one is genetic stability. Genetic stability, that means genetic stability or genetic variability, they are also stable. Third one is non-toxicity to humans. They are non-toxic for the humans and any other animals. Then ability to use cheaper substrate. Those strains which are selected are easily grow or use cheaper substrate for growing. Then elimination of the production of compound that may interfere with downstream processing. So we have to know what is downstream processing. Downstream processing refers to the recovery and purification of biosynthetic product, particularly pharmaceutical, from natural sources such as animal or plant tissue or fermentation broth. It also describes the series of operations required to take biological materials such as cell, tissue culture or plant tissue fluid from them. Through it, we can eliminate the production of compound that may interfere with the downstream processing. Then next one is to improve the use of carbon sources, reduction of cultivation cost, then shorter fermentation time. So these are the ideal characteristics that can be improved by strain improvement. So we can get this type of characteristic after strain improvement. What are the approaches for strain improvement? Generally, three approaches are there for strain improvement. First one is mutant selection, second one is recombination, third one is recombinant DNA technology. First one is mutant selection. So a mutation which is sudden and heritable change in the traits of an organism. So everyone know that mutation is any sudden change or alteration in the DNA sequence. Then application of mutagens to induce mutation is called mutagenesis. So what is mutagenesis? Mutagenesis is any fluctuation of the genome of the organism by a physical or chemical mutagen. Or when it is induced by any substances, then it is called mutagenesis. For example, when any physical or chemical agent that can induce the mutation, then it is called as mutagenesis. Agents capable of inducing mutations are called mutagens. So the agents which are capable of inducing mutation are known as mutagens. The mutagens may be of physical mutagens, chemical mutagens, physical mutagens like UV rays, X rays, gamma rays, and chemical mutagens like alkylating agents, acridine diets. So generally mutation is of two types. First one is spontaneous mutation, and second one is induced mutation. First one, mutation occurring without any specific treatment are called spontaneous mutation. And mutation are resulting due to a treatment with certain agents are known as induced mutation. So when mutation is occur spontaneously without any involvement of any agent or any specific treatment, then they are called spontaneous mutation. Then mutation are resulting due to treatment with certain agents, such as physical mutagens. They may be of chemical mutagens like alkylating agents, acridine diets, and UV rays, X rays, gamma rays. That this type of agent, when induced the mutation, then they are known as induced mutation. Many mutations bring about marked changes in the biochemical characters of practical interest. These are called major mutations. These can be used in strain improvement. For example, Streptomyces graecius produces streptomycin. After we can changes it to, after biochemical changes, we can it converted into, we can convert it into Manosidostreptomycin. Then for another example is Streptomyces oropharynx or specific strain S604 produces 6-dimethyl tetracycline in place of tetracycline. So we can get a desirable product from after strain improvement by biochemical changes or of our practical interest. In contrast, most improvement in biochemical production have been due to stepwise accumulation of so-called minor genes. So, for example, Penicillium chrysogenum strain E15-1 was obtained, which yield 55% more penicillin than the original strain. So after a stepwise accumulation, we can get higher product from the original or parental strain. That here from Penicillium chrysogenum strain E15-1, we can get 55% more penicillin than the original strain. Then reports on strain improvement by mutation. Carana and Medicella in 2006 lipase from Aspergillus japonicus MTCC 1975 mutation using UV HNO2 NTG showed 127%, 177%, 276% higher lipase yield than parent strain respectively. So then next report is first superior penicillin producing mutant that is Penicillium chrysogenum X1612 was isolated after X-ray mutagenesis. So we can get more product or for example lipase and penicillin from the strain improvement that yields more higher yielding, that has more higher yielding product, or we can get more amount of product from the original or parent strain. Then how to isolate the mutants, or what is the techniques to isolate the mutants? The following points highlights the four methods to detect and isolate mutants. The methods are, first one is replica plating techniques, Second one is resistance selection method. Third one is substrate utilization method. Fourth one is carcinogenicity test. Then coming to the first one, replica plating techniques. Lederberg and Lederberg in 1952 have given replica plating technique. This technique is used to detect auxotrophic mutants, which differentiate between mutant and wild type strain on the basis of ability to grow in the absence of an amino acid. So we have to know what is auxotrophic strain, auxotrophic mutants. So auxotrophic mutants are a special case of conditional lethal mutants in which the condition is presence or absence of a specific nutrient. If the essential things are lacking in the media and no growth occurs in the media, then it is called auxotrophic mutants. They do not produce any colony. And wild type mutant, that is the normal individual having normal phenotype, then we can easily isolate which is mutant type and which is wild type. But this technique. Then second one is resistance selection method. It is the other approach for isolation of mutants. Generally, the wild type cells are not resistant either to antibiotics or bacteriophages. Therefore, it is possible to grow the bacterium in the presence of the agent that is antibiotics or bacteriophage and look for the survivors. So we can easily isolate the wild type strain from which does not resistance to either antibiotics or bacteriophage. So it is easy to isolate the wild type from this technique or method. Third one is substrate utilization method. So this method is employed in the selection of bacteria. Several bacteria utilize only a few carbon sources. The cultures are plated onto the medium containing alternate carbon sources. Any colony that grows on medium can be used, can use the substrate and are possibly mutants. So these can be isolated. So several bacteria only uses a few carbon sources. Then in this case also we can easily isolate the mutants that can be grown on a medium of using substrates, and they are the mutants. Then fourth one is carcinogenicity test to identify the environmental carcinogens that cause mutation and induce cancer in organism. It is based on detecting potential of carcinogens and testing for mutagenicity in bacteria. So we have to know what is a carcinogen. Carcinogen is a substance that can cause cancer. So there is a specific procedure to do carcinogenicity test to detect cancer. Coming to the aims.
This part you go a little quicker. We have time limitation.
Okay, sir. MS in 1973 developed a method for deletion of mutagenicity of carcinogen, which is commonly known as Ames test. It is widely used to detect the carcinogens. The Ames test is mutational reversion assay in which several special strains of Salmonella trypumurium are employed. Each strain contains a different mutation in the operation of histidine biosynthesis. So here in this case, in a test tube, we can add a test tube, we can add a oxotroph of Salmonella typhimurium. Then we could, then we are added to a two different plates, that is plate A and plate B. After that, we are incubate this plate at room temperature, at 37 degrees centigrade. So after some time, we can see that in plate A, there is less number of bacteria, a few numbers are seen, but in plate B, there is more or more comparatively more than the colonies, more than the number plate one colonies are visible. So we can identify that higher number of bacteria or colony represent the greater mutagenicity. Then coming to the recombination, then it is defined as formation of new genes combination among those present in different strain. So recombination occurs when two molecules of DNA exchange pieces of their genetic material with each other. Recombination is used for both genetic analysis as well as strain improvement to generate new products. So recombination may be based on following types. First one is transformation, conjugation, others like crossover or transduction. Next one is protoplast fusion. The fusion between non-producing strain of two species, that is Streptomyces griseus and Streptomyces and tangiomariensis, has yielded a strain that produces indolizomycin, a new indolizine antibiotic. So this is the transformation. What is transformation? Transformation is a process of uptake of foreign DNA from environment to the cell. It is called transformation. Or transformation is the transfer of genetic material from donor cell to recipient cells. So these are the DNA fragments from the donor cell. So this is the recipient cell, and these are the capital small a, small b. These are the chromosomal DNA of the recipient cell. So recipient cell take up the donor DNA. So here capital A and capital B are the DNA fragment of donor cells, which can be transformed into the recipient cell. Then after the process of recombination, the donor bacterium, the part of the donor bacterium is transformed into the chromosomal DNA. This is the capital B, which is the DNA fragments from the donor cell are transformed into the chromosomal DNA. So this is a genetically transformed cell here. So from DNA, a part of the DNA from donor cell to recipient cell is transformed. And so genetically, transformed cell. And coming to the next one, conjugation. So what is conjugation? Conjugation is the transfer of DNA from one cell to another cell through conjugative bridge formation. It's called conjugation. So this is
Mr. Bania, please don't spend your time on describing conjugation. It is expected that the students that know it.
Okay, sir.
You move fast to the next slide.
Okay, sir. Sorry. So this is the A plus L cell is the donor cell, A minus cell is the recipient cells. So this is the conjugative pylos that can be helped to transport the genetic material. So F plasmid is also known as a fertility factor or conjugative plasmid. So the cell which is having F plasmid are called F plus cells, and the cell which is having, do not having F plasmid are called F minus cells. So here F plus cell have F plasmid. Then after replication, one strand of F plasmid is transformed into the recipient cell, that is F minus cells. Then F minus cell getting F plasmid are transformed into F plus cells. So this is the conjugation process. The next one is protoplast fusion. So in protoplast fusion, we have to take two different strands from the two different species, that is strand A and strand B. So we have to exclude the cell wall from the plant cell. We only left with some distracted cell membrane along with other component. That thing is called as protoplast for the plant. First, you can isolate protoplast to intimate physical contact mechanically. Then we can apply a chemical treatment that is known as fusazone treatment or other like polyethylene glycol or sodium nitrate, because it can cause massive fusion product. Then after fusion, then fused the protoplast can be fused. That is it is known as heterokaryon. By heterokaryon means when two different type of nuclei fused together, that is known as heterokaryon. Then this is the hybrid from two different nuclei or two different protoplast of different strand. Next one is recombinant DNA technology. So RDT or recombinant DNA technology or genetic engineering involves in the isolation and cloning of genes of interest, production of necessary gene construct using appropriate enzymes, then transfer and expression of these genes into an suitable host organism. This technique has been used to achieve two broad objectives: production of recombinant proteins and metabolic engineering. The first one, recombinant proteins. These are the proteins produced by the transformed gene or transgene. They themselves are of commercial value. For example, insulin, interferons are produced in bacteria. So recombinant protein is a protein encoded by a gene that is recombinant DNA that has been cloned in a system that support expression of the gene. For example, insulin and interferon. Then metabolic engineering. When metabolic activities of an organism are modified by introducing into it transgene, which affect enzymatic transport or regulatory function of its cell, is known as metabolic engineering. For example, overproduction of the amino acid isoleucine in Corynebacterium glutamicum and ethanol by E. coli. And product modification include new enzymes which modifies the product of existing biosynthetic pathway, that is conversion of cephalosporin C into 7 amino cephalosporanic acid by D-amino acid oxidase in a chrysogenome. Then completely new metabolite formation include in which all the genes of a new pathway are transferred. For example, in E. coli, transfer of two genes for polyhydroxybutyrate synthesis from alkali genes eutrophos. Then enhanced growth include enhanced substrate utilization. For example, in E. coli, glutamate dehydrogenase converted into M by the help of M methylotropos carbon conversion increased from 4% to 7%. By enhancing the substrate utilization, we can enhance the growth. Then novel genetic technologies are of two types: metabolic engineering and genome sampling. Then metabolic engineering, the existing pathways are modified or entirely new ones are introduced through the manipulation of the genes so as to improve the yields of the microbial product, eliminate or reduce undesirable side products, or shift to the production of an entirely new product. So metabolic engineering is purposeful modification of cellular networks, including metabolic and gene regulatory and signaling networks, to achieve desirable goals such as enhanced metabolites, including pharmaceuticals, biofuel, biochemicals, and biotechnological products. So it has been used to overproduce the amino acid isoleucine in Corynebacterium glutamicum and ethanol.
Keep it. Already you have told this. Keep it. Next. Move to the next, actually.
Okay. Next one is genome sampling. It is a novel technique for strain improvement that allows for recombination between multiple strains at each generation and several rounds of recursive genome fusion. So recursive genome fusion is nothing but the cross mating, were carried out, resulting in the final improved strain involving genetic trait from multiple initial strain. Then coming to the applications of strain improvement. So first application is a large scale production of vaccines, enzyme, interferon, growth factor, blood clotting factors in the field of microbiology to improve the microbes' productivities or characteristics. This is the most important characteristic application of this strain improvement. Then treatment of genetic diseases like SCID by rDNA technology and production of medically useful biological products like insulin. In conclusion, this step has been taken by farms in order to gap the bridge between basic knowledge and industrial application. The task of both discovering new microbial compounds and improving the synthesis of known ones have become more and more challenging. The tremendous increase in fermentation productivity and resulting decrease in costs have come about mainly by using mutagenesis. In recent years, recombinant DNA technology has been applied. The promise of the future is via extensive of new genetic techniques like metabolic engineering and genome sampling. The choice of approaches which should be taken will be driven by the economics of the biotechnological process and the genetic tools available for the strain of interest. These are the references. Thank you everyone.
Any queries? Open for the question. Open for the question answer session.
Amartya, you have a question from a participant. Is it possible to develop an E. coli strain with improved tolerance to green chemicals using genome sampling? Did you get the question?
Yes, sir.
We try to answer. Sir,
Yes, we can. We can modify or change the from biochemical changes.
So he's asking, is it possible to develop an E. coli strain with improved tolerance to green chemicals using genome sampling? Green chemicals means that you have to understand that atomic waste, something like that, in the environment, or whatever waste in the environment, whatever chemicals, those are green chemicals. Can we reduce that by using this improved E. coli strain?
No, let me put the question like this. Is it possible to make E. coli more radiation resistant? If you answer this question, then the question is going to be self-answered to the question.
Yes, sir, it is possible. Because specific strain, specific type of E. coli strain has been identified. That is, reduce the chemicals or any waste material.
Okay, next question.
What are wild type cells?
Wild type cell are the individual having the normal phenotype that can be selected for strain improvement. Wild type strain is the normal type of normal phenotype, or the individual having the normal phenotype.
Usually, strain is written with subscript plus 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 plus. What does it mean? That means it's capable of synthesizing all of its requirement. Therefore, it is going to be independent of the utilization. So such is called as the wild strain. Usually he is referring wild strain, but in industrial microbiology, the appropriate terminology is prototroph.
Yes, sir.
It is a prototroph. So usually by telling the prototroph means you start with a wild strain.
Yes, sir.
Which is efficient, which is going to be independent with respect to its utilization and all that.
Yes, sir.
Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next question.
Hello, Amartya.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, can you tell what is auxotrophic mutant?
Yes, sir. oxytropic mutants are the mutants that is a special case of conditional mutant lethal mutants in which the condition is presence or absence of a specific nutrients or if the essential things are lacking in the media or media then no growth occurs then that type of strain is called oxytropic mutants
so it is the opposite how can you differentiate between the oxytropic strain and a normal strain
yes sir oxytropic strain do not produce any colony but normal strain
your question is in a, you are answering in a very wrong direction it's not the answer
Okay, sir.
The question is how the oxytropic strains are going to be different from the prototropic strain. For example, let us consider a prototrop.
Yes, sir.
Sir, methionine isoleucine it can synthesize. Therefore, it is methio plus isoleucine plus, and you have mutated it. As a result, you have got an oxytropic strain. It may be methionine plus but isoleucine minus. So that's what the oxytropic mutant. All oxytropes are the mutants actually. Oxytropes means they are derived from the prototropes. And how they are derived? Their journey is because of the mutation. Therefore, all oxytropes, they are spontaneously called as the oxytropic mutants. And very often, instead of writing oxytropic mutants, it is written that they are oxytropes. Is it clear to you, the question, person who put the question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
One more question is there. How could gene supply be bad? Be a bad thing?
What was the question?
How could gene suppling be a bad thing?
Insuppling is a bad practice. Insuppling is a bad practice. Comment. I think the question is like this. The question putter.
Yes.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
Does it mean that insulting is a bad practice?
Asmita Das.
Asmita Das.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Is it the question? Can I change the language of the question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. So you just comment why it is a bad practice.
Sir, it is a bad practice. Because it breaks the favorable combination of traits.
No, not like that. You are far away. You are miles away from the answer. Answer is, insuppling is a bad practice because there is no standardized protocol for this. You try. You may get, you may not get actually. So at the end of the day, the entire actually your entire I mean your entire efforts it may be effortless may not give you the result and all that follow this so that's the reason why once upon a time we started with the mutation but mutation was actually a very raw practice and all that so we tried mutation sometimes you get sometimes you do not get at that time the technology was not developed but right now when recombinant DNA technology, metabolic engineering, they came into the picture, which are going to be very purposeful and they have been well protocolized. All this. So there is a way to go to the station. You just not go straight east or west like that. There are roads to the station. So therefore, the resuppling or insuppling is considered as a bad practice. Is considered as a practice because sometimes you may get, sometimes you may not get. When you are trying to do with an organism, the organism has a lot of genes and all that. You want to get rid of certain genes into cryptic condition. You want certain genes to get themselves into activated condition. All of this. So that you are trying in a very raw method. So therefore, it is a bad practice. The question putter actually. Whose name was ka question thala
sir Sasmita
sir Sasmita hello Sasmita have you got the question answer
thank you sir
okay thank you Then any more questions? Sushil.
Sir, yes, sir. There is one more question.
Yeah,
during
you are...
the mutant, during the mutation selection, that is like substrate utilization process, you saying by using special carbon source, we select. But the aim is to the strain should use simple carbon and nitrogen source. Justify. This is a question from Dinesh Padina.
Yeah, you, this is a question. You answer. This question can be well answered.
Amartya.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Did you get the question?
Yes, sir.
Why do you, I am going to straight convert this question into this particular problem. Why do you go for unusual carbon utilization? And thereafter, you are going to tag a strain with unusual carbon utilization. When we have to develop this strain production capacity using usual carbon.
Sir, because unusual carbon sources can cause mutation. Possibly can cause.
No.
Because, sir.
Let me answer this question also.
Okay, sir.
Okay, who is the answer? Who is the question putter?
This is Dinesh. It from JIT Biotechnology. Dinesh.
Here initially you are going to try to utilization of the unusual sugar in order to tag a strain. Actually, a strain is there. You have mutated. The prototrop is going to utilize the normal lactose, glucose, or something like that. But unusual is going to utilize a pentose sugar. Follow this. So therefore, you can tag that. Follow. And once you tag that particular strain, which has going to exhibit this unusual sugar utilization, you can work with the further and all that. So that's the reason actually.
Dinesh, did you get your answer? Dinesh.
Mr. Dinesh, have you got your answer? It is as if actually there are 1,000 people in a...
Yes, sir. Yes.
And from that market, actually, your job is to trace out the persons who are culprits. Follow this. So therefore, you are going to get into that, actually. So by that, you are going to get into this train. Maybe further work is going to make this train to reach the target and all that. Follow this. So these are the intermediate stages and all that. Somebody is going to tell that how this mutated strain is going to be different from the parent strain, then you can show. Now look, this was utilizing sugar A, but this mutated strain is unable to utilize the sugar A, rather it is going to utilize the sugar Z. So therefore it is mutated. And I am going to work further on this mutated strain so that I am going to get the desired strain. Dinesh. Hello, Dinesh.
Yes, sir. He replied.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Any more questions?
Yes, sir, there is a question. What is the important factors needed to be taken care of while making medium for fermentation? Yes. The important factors that taking care for fermentation process are first one is the metabolic activities of the bacteria, that is lactobacillus. Or lactic acid bacteria, then important factors like temperature, pH, acidity, and availability of nutrients. Yes, that one.
So, is it over actually? The question answer session is over or still there?
Sir, there is no question in the chat box.
Okay.
If someone want to ask, they can ask.
No, no, you have to. Okay, if it is over, then I will give my conclusion.
Yes, sir. Okay. I think it is over.
Okay. So it's time for the conclusion. Yes, right from the beginning, I told you that strain improvement is an evergreen topic. The topic is going to be a problem and is also going to be a solution provider in the field of the industrial microbiology. And as long as the strain needs to be improved, the microbiologist sitting in a remote corner in an industry is going to be very, very important VIP. Because everything is dependent upon the strain. In you go to the industrial microbial unit, their hero is the strain. Jaise Ramayana mein Ram nahi hone to Ramayana nahi hota, just like that. So strain is very important. And the strain has to be intervened appropriately. Somewhere I was looking, actually I got this phrase that strain improvement is a journey, it is a great journey from a prototropic strain to auxotropic strain. Follow this journey, this journey is going, this journey that begins from a prototrop ends with an auxotrop. And this journey is very continuous, very strategic, and the journey has to be accomplished by microbiological technique, which is going to be adopted by a microbiologist. Follow? So therefore, the microbiology, this speaks that microbiology in one way, it is very much related to the fundamental science, but in other way, it is also related to the technology. So therefore, this strain improvement, in fact, it is a link between science and technology. And this link is very important because it is going to push a prototropic strain to an auxotropic strain. It is as good as pushing something from lab to land or pushing something from science to technology and all that. So, and this conversion is not simply for cosmetic. It has certain, I mean, it is very, very relevant because the industry, whenever you are going to develop a industry, microbial industry, maybe any industry, there the productivity is very important. Because ultimately it is the productivity which is going to give us the profit. If profit is good, then the industry is going to be robust and all that. Hello. So therefore, this particular aspect is called as the bioprocess economics. After you work out a strain, a desirable strain, which is going to be overproducing or something like that, the bioprocess economists, they are going to sit with this strain. And they are going to tell that how much we are going to get this. And then only you are going to have the applicability and all that. Just one example, let me tell you. When penicillin was discovered in 1942, and it came to the market actually in 1945 and all that. At that particular time, the penicillin was not affordable because the penicillium chrysogenum, which was initially designed, that was only giving 100 units per ml actually. The production was this much. So with that, it was calculated only 0.1% of the world population, they can utilize the penicillin, the antibiotics. The others, because of the lack of the money, because they are poverty, they have the poverty, they cannot utilize. So therefore, this is not going to be the solution giver to the entire world population. So the entire world started working on the strain improvement. They improved the strain. At that time, recombinant DNA technology was not there in the picture. So they wanted mutagens and all that. And ultimately, they developed the strain. They developed the strain, which was responsible for giving at least 51 times more the production what the wild strain or the prototropic strain of Pen Alexander Fleming was giving and all that. Then only it was affordable. This. So good many antibiotics, whenever they emerged in the market, they're very costly. But simultaneously, because of the working of the microbiologists for the strain improvement and subsequently by through the work of the bioprocess economics, they are going to be affordable and all that. All this. So therefore, this is a great topic. Everybody should know, particularly those who have got an interest in microbiology or those who are studying in the microbiology and all that, they should know there are certain things about the talk. I'll be telling, first of all, thank you for telling. But let me tell you, while you are borrowing a slide from the internet and all that, you have to give certain mind. This is with respect to Amartya. Follow this. For example, strain. There are good number of convenient definition of a strain. Why do you call this as a group of species? It is a wrong thing. Simply, you try to define strain as a variant, having certain
it is a genetic variant.
Characteristic features. When you say it's a group of species, it's a wrong thing. Follow this. So don't, adopt everything that you come across in the internet. Follow this. There are certain, garbages in the internet and all that. Then always utilize the term actually prototype for the wild type. Follow this. Then you could have, avoided recombination because it is normally taught something like that. Rather, you should have given certain focus on the metabolic engineering. It's an upcoming subject and all that. And in fact, in future, I will be telling somebody to take up this metabolic engineering in details and is going to deliver a talk. So therefore, I'll be telling that this topic as a journey from prototrop to auxotrop will be continuing as long as microbiological based industry will be operating. And definitely microbiological industry has to operate because we need antibiotics for our survival, for our healthcare system and all that. So strain improvement or this particular journey is going to continue, something like that. So with this, I thank everybody, for the talk, and thank Mr. Bania for this. But in future, he have to take, care of certain things so that he can improve upon on that. So these are my comments and all that. So I think with this, the last agenda is going to be there, Sushil.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, last agenda, that is vote of thanks. And I will be requesting Dr. Haraprasad Mahapatra. Henceforward, he will be in charge of the student interactive program for the MSI. Dr. Haraprasad Mahapatra, please.
Sir. Thank you, sir.
Sir, I want to thank all of sir.
Okay, Dr. Mahapatra, please. Okay, thank you, Amartya.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you. Dr. Haraprasad. Haraprasad, who is it?
Sir, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, henceforth, it is a great opportunity in part of me that you have given me the charge as the seminar, student-student interactions. So, I think this type of seminar is very fruitful in part of the students as well as the participants. So henceforth we will continue as usual the student-student interaction programs with the more effectively. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. And let me thank you. Thank profusely our national president, Professor M. Deshmukh, for joining. And for his words of encouragement, always his encouragement actually is a perennial actually thing from Professor Deshmukh's lip. So thank you, Professor Deshmukh. And I thank also the GIT University Gunapur to host this seminar. I thank all faculties of GIT University Gunapur. I also thank all of our coordinators, both zonal as well as local, for their presence. And also I thank all the students, those who have participated for this. So by simply participating, it is going to do a wonder to you, in the sense, instead of writing a 500 book, page book, if you watch the show for this type of interaction program for 30 minutes or something like that, it is going to be more effective for you. So I thank you. Thank you, Sushil. And
thank you,
everybody.
Sir, one thing I want to add this. Sir.
Okay.
Am I audible? Okay. Sir, we will have to make a queue of speakers. Those who want to deliver their talks, and one